Hi again. This is exercise number 3 on word processors, and today we are going to work on creating diagrams like this one in the image. So this exercise is asking you to start a new document and create this, and then make sure that you make a group with all the elements, selecting them with the control key. So let's get started. This is my document in Word. So you need to use shapes here. And first one is a rectangle. So now I can draw a rectangle here. There you go. And I'm gonna make it look like the one in the exercise. You see this thick black line outside. It's quite thick and the text is white. All right. So when you click in a shape, it will take you to these format options. And here is where you can change the color. It's more of a light blue, I think, something like this. And here is the outline of the shape. And we want it black and we want it thicker. 3 points will do. So now we have to write the text inside. So for that, you only need to double click inside and write it. That's it. And now I'm going to format that text, make it a little bigger. That is quite similar. Okay, so next, instead of going with the lines, I'm going to create this. You see, this is a rectangle too, but it is rounded. The edges are rounded, and we have a shape for that too. I'm going back to insert here, and shapes, and here is the rounded rectangle. You also have it here, by the way. So I draw it, and I'm going to make it look like the one in the exercise. So it's kind of yellow, orange, and the text is black, and the line outside is quite thick too. So let's go for it. This is the fill. The color is like an orange thing, something like that. And the line outside is much thicker, 3 points. Also, the color is black. And now I'm going to write the entrada, the text here. I'm going to select it, same type of font, not that big, but a little bit bigger. That's okay, I guess. Now, we want the text in black. In black. There you go. All right. So we need 2 more like this. And now, instead of repeating what I just did to create that shape, it will be much faster. If I just select it and copy it, and then I paste it. I'm gonna use Ctrl V for that, and I'll paste it again because I need 2 more. There and there. So these new shapes have the same format as the one I created first, and I only need to change the text now. All right. So that was easy. I only need to create the lines now. So let's go. Insert, shapes. Some of these shapes are lines. So that's my line. I don't like it so thin and so light. So I'm going to change that. I want it much thicker, 3 points, and I want it in black. Okay, so more lines. I do this big one here. Again, black. And again, 3 points. And now these two here. There you go. Black, 3 points. And I think you understand why I do this. That was quick. So, ooh, look at that. Perfect now. So in the exercise, they're telling you, make sure that you group the elements when you finish, selecting them with the control key. So yeah, I'm going to select this one. You see, it is selected now. Now I press the key control. And every line, I am pressing the key control now. And I click on this, I click on this, this one, two, this shape, and this shape. Now, everything is selected. I need to go now to format, yes, okay, to group and group again. All right, so now all the elements in this diagram are together, so that means I can move them all together. I can even make them a bit bigger or a bit smaller if I like to, but this is useful because what if I wanted to move the whole thing to another place? I will have to move the elements one by one, and I don't want that. So it is very useful. I guess I'll have to do it again now. There you go. One here, 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 this. This and this one too. You can also right click and here you go, agrupar. That's nice. Let's see what's next. Here now, the exercise is asking you to create a text box under every peripheral type here with examples. And then we have to group them all together. Okay, so text boxes are very useful when you are working with word processors, because sometimes you want a text that is outside the paragraphs and a text that you can move when wherever you want to. So if you click here in text box, okay, let's go with the simple one. That is what I wanted. This is keyboard, mouse, microphone. Okay, I'm gonna type that. Teclado, ratón, microphone. And now we apply the bullets here, which, as you know, are here. That's right. I think that's fine. And this text box has a line outside, and I don't want that. I can change it again if I go here to format, and the line outside, I could control the thickness, but what I want is no line outside. So I click there and the line has disappeared. It is still a text box, but it's gone now. So instead of repeating the process for this, I am going to copy and paste this text box and then change the text inside. So I select it. Now Control C, Control V. There's another one, Control V again. Okay. And now I'll change the text, which for these peripherals are screen, speakers, and printer. Right, I'm going to modify the shape of this text box, so okay, that's it. So this will only take a line, and I will move it where I want it to be. I think that looks fine, so I will select this. This is the whole diagram that we created before, and now I press Control again. I select this, and this one, and guess what goes next? Right click, group. And I have it all together now. I can take it whenever, wherever I want. I can copy it and paste it or anything. So that's it. I only need to save the document with this name, Practica 3. I'm going to show you how to do that just in case. Save as, you choose a folder, Practica 3. There you go. And that is the file that you need to attach to the task. I hope you learned some things with this. See you later.